stay front line till the law call my number. I be that boy you gon' remember. I'ma be that boy you gon' remember, that's right. I be that boy you gon' remember. To Hawk of Bay front line till the law call my number.
If you a friend of the Moors, then you a friend of mine. I was told to watch my enemies, now hold my line. Those who speak against the prophet, they speak against me. And I'm speaking about the prophet over Drew Ali, who was the first to remind you and bind you back to Morocco, the mountains, Mississippi, and Quebec. Told you you wasn't black, proved it with straight facts. You tripping off trunks, you need to be tripping off that. Now here we go again, acting like you a slave. The same people took European on the bay. And looking at women, buying European hair. No love for self, but do the men really care? Hell now, cause they got a love for Europe. Whole generation chasing pills, weed and syrup. Yeah, they love Lil Yachty, Tucci, Gucci, Kodak, Amigos, Ross, Lucy. But when a love for the woman look like your mother, I guess they say it's all black when it's under the cover. Now, I be that boy you gon' remember. I'ma be that boy you gon' remember. That's right. I be that boy you gon' remember. To Hawk of Bay front line till the law call my number. I be that boy you gon' remember. I'ma be that boy you gon' remember. That's right. I be that boy you gon' remember. To Hawk of Bay front line till the law call my number. All you super scholars holler. This era for the workers. You ain't building on the ground, then you worse than a twerker. You look and sound good, but that's only on the surface. Probably working for the people. Now tell me what your purpose. Ain't worried about your homie, but know that I know. Every mo that rockin' fast, he ain't my bro. Yeah, you know I ain't slow. I seen it all before. How they try to kill the prophet, it was all for dough. And some got it right now. Don't say that I'm not down. I'm coming for my bastard state. I want my town, my sheriff, my stores, my school, my nation. Sick and tired of the procrastination and debate. Y'all keep hating when love is the savior. You don't love yourself, so you can't love your neighbor. That's why you killing, fighting, Murray out of your race. If you ain't for Moore's world, then get out of my face. Cause Chinese love China, Italians love Italy. If the Houston love the Moore's world, come on and build it with me. Let's go. I be that more you gon' remember. I'ma be that more you gon' remember. That's right. I be that more you gon' remember. To Hawk of Bay front line till the law call my number.
Check, check. What's going on? Welcome to another edition, another beautiful edition of No Bullish TV, No Bullish Podcast. Today, we have Zahmyre Harris on, man, the owner of the one and only Bad Medicine. I honestly think this dog and this gentleman I'm about to bring on is kind of under the radar, man. I don't know why, man. He has... He has a very nice dog, proven producer, and we're going to bring my mans on, but you know how I do. I play my guests on, so.
I don't want no problems with us, you know what I'm saying? I don't want no problems with us.
Hey, keep fucking niggas up.
The emergency brakes broke.
We the best music.
There ain't no stopping this shit anyway, though. Ain't no such thing as real life. It ain't no stopping this. I'm the youngest nigga popping shit. They wanna stop the fire, but it's too late. This shit got super lit. You see the way I pull it, bitch. You see the way these diamonds hit. Nigga, try to touch my chain, you gon' see the way this 40 kick. They don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. They don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. They don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. You don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. Why I just got hot in here? Ola Witt just walked in. I don't be with fuck niggas, but I keep my F in. Bro, gon' move the double R, we got somebody blocked in. Just saw my partner from Atlanta, he say you fresh as fuck, twin. Swing that stick like Jackie Robinson, and we slide home. He so innocent in real life, but gangsta on the phone. Funny how she say that I'm the dog, but ate me off the bone. I heard her nigga mad, she came home smelling like my cologne. All I know is God, ain't no stopping or no slowing down. I don't want that nigga around me if he ain't gon' pow pow. I don't want that necklace if that Cuban link don't bang bow. I don't want that pretty girl if she don't know how to work her mouth. We look like some old people, everybody got a stick. No, my phone ain't never dead, but I pull up 5%. When I walk, my chains go back and forth like they in an argument. If you stay at this car too long, through the trunk. They don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. They don't want no problems with us, it ain't safe. fuck with us, you ain't safe.
I'm in the cut, sizzle, I'm a cutthroat little nigga. I been fucking since December, now her butt ain't getting bigger. Nobody ain't told me I was tripping when I picked up a pistol. Started off with good intention, how the fuck I turned.
My bad, I gotta cut that Kodak off. My bad, man. I forgot Kodak was on this. What's going on, Zahmyre? Am I saying your name right? Saying your name properly?
What's up, bro? Yeah, you saying it right.
That's you know, I got soul in me, man. You know, I know how to read that soul. Your mama named you with soul, man. You know what I'm saying? Because it's not spelled the traditional way. You know, she put her own twist on it. Yeah. So how you doing, brother?
I'm good, bro. How are you?
Hey, man, I'm doing well, man. It's an honor to have you on. I wanted to talk about how old are you, first of all? How what's your age?
24.
24 years old. And can you tell everybody what you do a little bit about yourself?
So other than dogs, I play pro soccer. So right now I'm traveling with the Virgin Islands national team. So I play soccer, and then, you know, of course, I'm running around with these dogs all the time. So that's about it right now.
Man, hey, I appreciate the time because I know you have a very busy schedule. And I honestly, I think a lot of people don't really know that you're a professional soccer player, man. And this, I knew it. I'm a fan, man. And I want to be the first one to tell you from the bully world, man, that I'm proud of you, man, of what you're doing. Because it's some hard work. Soccer is a tough sport, man.
It is. I appreciate it, man.
So, what got you into dogs? Do you have the common story that most of the people in American bully world have? You know, I had a pit bull, or somebody in my family had a pit bull. How did you get into dogs?
So originally I wanted to be a vet when I was younger. I was in school. So when I was in college, I was going to school in South Georgia, you know, in a rural, it's so country down there. So when I first
You're an AT alien, though. You're an AT alien, yeah, right? Yeah, I'm from Atlanta. Okay. Yeah. All right. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
So
go ahead.
I was going to school in South Georgia, real country area. It was called Americus. I think probably 1,000 people lived there, something like that. So I got into the dog. Like, I had dogs already, but then I ended up getting a bully. But it was standards. I was working with standards at first. So, you know, in the country, most people, they like bigger dogs, standards, taller dogs. So I was breeding those. And then once I moved to Atlanta, I was like, I mean, the whole market changed. Once I graduated college, I was like, I got to get in the pockets because, you know, a lot of people up here, like I stay downtown, like in the middle of the city. So nobody wants, you know, the taller dogs with more drive. So I went shorter. And that's when I got bad medicine. I also bought another female that I have too, my foundation female. And I've just been doing well since then.
And so how did you know bad medicine was the dog? Like, I didn't know shots fired was the dog when I, because I just got into dogs. So I really didn't know what, you know, a supreme stud looks like, because I whiffed out with a pet that we bought named Bane, and he wasn't a show dog. He was like flawed up, you know? So I was kind of confused on what they wanted as, you know, a show dog. This was in 2016. So, you know, I was looking at, you know, the champion class and grand champion, seeing what, you know, but these are adult dogs. They're not puppies. Yeah. You know, it doesn't tell you how to actually pick these actual dogs that are beloved by the world, actually, you know, when you bring them out, you know, like the Brims, like the Shots Fired, like the Bad Medicines, you know, like dogs like that. That how did you know that dog was the one? When did you say, damn, this dog is it?
So it's actually crazy. I don't think a lot of people know how I got him. So it's a guy named Charlie. I actually respect him a lot. He's the one who produced him, Charlie Blackwell. So he produced him. And Charlie, you know, I don't know if you're familiar with his yard. He used to have a lot of dogs. I think probably, you know, 10, 20 big, like all the dogs he had were like bad medicine. All of them.
Okay.
Most of the time they were females, though. So only males he had was Silver Surfer, which grand champs, And then
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah,
I got.
So he produced him, and then he produced Bad Medicine. So when he would take pictures and post them on Facebook with all the dogs, Bad Medicine would be in the background. So this was when Bad Medicine was probably like 6-7 months, and I was just asking him like, "Who's that blue dog back there? Who's that blue dog back there?" And you know, at first, you know, people don't want to sell them, you know. And after a while, one day he hit me up. I don't remember. It was probably 2 or 3 in the morning. And I think he was like, "Yeah, I'll let you have them. Like, I'll sell them to you." And he was like, I was the first one that he hit up. And as soon as he messaged me, I sent him the deposit. But I just knew around this time, you know, this was, I want to say 3 years ago when the extreme, like, you know, there's waves of the extreme pockets. Like, you have like the Magoos and the Casas, and then you have where it jumped to the Brims, which is a different generation in my opinion. So once I saw him was around the time when like Brims and Cash and all of them were coming up. So I was like, you know, ain't nobody had that over here. South Georgia, Georgia period, or Florida, all the states in the Southeast, nobody had a dog like that.
Right.
And he was up in Minnesota. So yeah, I was like, let me get him, send a deposit. And ever since then, he sent him down. When I got him, he was like 8 months, 9. It still had his ears on, but you could tell he was, man, that he's been huge. Ever since he jumped out the van when the transporter brought him, I was like, man, yeah, he's going to be special.
Have you ever shown him? I know you've been to some stack offs with him,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Is he ABKC registered? Is he UKC registered? Have you shown him?
So honestly, that's another funny story. So when I got him, I couldn't get him to walk on a leash for the longest. I want to say it probably took me 1.5 years.
Damn.
I had to like pay trainers and people had to come out to my house. Like it was a long process to get him to walk on a leash. And by the time he was on the leash, I was like, man, I'm not about to put him out there. Like, I think he was probably, I want to say he'll be 4 this year on Christmas. He was born the day before Christmas. So once I got him walking, I was like, man, I'm not going to put him in the show. I'd rather show his offspring now.
So to capitalize off that was going to be my next question. To capitalize off that, this beautiful specimen that you have, to actually create to produce your own creation of a bad medicine that you picture in your head, because I'm pretty sure you have, it's not bad medicine, it's a better version of bad medicine that you have planned to produce. So do you have a game plan for that? Are you actually gearing up for that right now?
So honestly, I'm really kind of a perfectionist. So I already have 2 studs off of him.
Okay.
But they're only 6 months. So one stud is off of Bad Medicine bred to a Brim daughter.
Okay.
So I haven't told anybody about that one. So whenever.
So this is, you heard it here for the first time on No Bullish Television. Brim meets Bad Medicine.
Yeah,
that's a serious combination right there, brother.
Yeah, that's gonna be the one. He's of course Bad Medicine's on the top side. The mom is Brim is her dad, and then her mom is off of Casablanca and Hugo Boss. So that's the one stud I have, and he's a lilac tribe. So he's going to be, you know, he's going to be special when I bring him out. And then I have another one who's 2 times Bad Medicine that he's hiding as well. And then my foundation female, who I was saying, she's off of like original muscle tone blood, like Magoo. I don't know if you're familiar with that dog, Quad. She's a black and white female, or Ciroc, all those muscle tone dogs.
I'm trying to share what this beautiful dog looks like. All right, so there he is right here. That's him right there.
Yeah, man,
that's Bad Medicine.
So I got that, and then I have a female. She's actually, she's swelling right now. So once she goes in the heat, I'm probably going to run her to him, and then that'll be
that's
another.
That's him right there you got stacked up?
Yeah, that's him. That's him.
Man, look at that. Look at that top line, y'all.
Yeah,
he's, and he's close to the extreme. He's like on the line of extreme and pocket. You know, he's like the kind of like the best, almost like the best of both worlds when you're messing with a dog like this.
Yeah, because you know a lot of what I've noticed with the extreme dogs. Well, I feel like ever since looking at the 20K stack off they had the other day,
right?
I feel like it's changing a little, but from going to a lot of shows, I've seen a lot of the extreme dogs are more on the fatter side.
Right.
Like a whole lot of, and with him, I don't really like all the extra, you know, weight. I'd rather it be more like toned up and then be extreme. But I feel like that's how it's kind of becoming now, though. A lot of these dogs are more like, you know, lean, but still extreme, not like overly done, because you do see some that can't even move.
So what are you, are you going more towards the I have a new name for the stack off dogs. It's not disrespectful, but the show prize dogs. That's what I was gonna call them, because that's what they actually are. You know, they're there to show up at a show to win a certain amount of money that people are betting on. You know what I'm saying? Or people are putting money up for who are throwing the show, or their side bets going on. Trust and believe that there's people betting money, you know what I'm saying, on this event. And I'm pretty sure, to be honest with you, it was in the probably, if not seven figures that was going around between the 20K that was put up and side bets. I'm pretty sure it was in the high six figures that was bet it all the way around within this, and we haven't seen anything like this in the dog world.
Yeah.
So this is why I give respect to. I don't have to like the dogs, you know what I'm saying? But I can respect what these brothers are doing, because they are working like we are, and I know they're trying to perfect and they're trying to add the bonuses on what they're trying to do. So what this question was going to lead me to what are you looking for, brother? Are you looking for that show prize dog, or are you looking for that show dog that actually can win in the ABKC? Because I don't know if you can you can straddle both lines, because look at seven. Yeah. Done, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to Seven and you know, everybody that was involved with that situation. And you know, that dog, you know, somebody said that it looked like he ate like three or four people after the Jacksonville show, and God, they were lying, man. The dog's impressive. So congratulations to the winners. But are you gearing more towards that, the show dog, or the prize dog that can stack off on a stack table?
So honestly, I feel like with each breeding, I do like, you know, both. Like, I feel like I have some breeding set up for the shows, and I have some where I want to go extreme. But honestly, lately I've more so been, I honestly like my females to be extreme. I don't really too much care about my males being overdone, because if it was up to me, I'd just go stack a female. Because like I was saying, a female I've been heat now, she's wider than him in the chest.
Wow. Yeah, that says a lot.
Yeah, so I'm more of a female. You know, I like the females. I like them to be more extreme and, you know, chill around the house, produce puppies for me. But if they end up extreme, they end up extreme. But
right,
I like
you're not guaranteed. You're not guaranteed one or the other. If you know it's going to be one or the other, so it is what it is. You know, if I have an extreme bull and I can do good with this bull, oh, he's going to be on the stack table on your ass, and he's going to be winning some 20K shows. And I'm pretty sure it's going to be more than 20K now. I'm pretty sure the next show going to be probably double that. You know what I'm saying? 50K around there. I think they might do that. You know what I'm saying? I'm telling you, man. Yeah, I think you're the youngest person besides Logan that and Christine. But before them. Well, not before Logan, because I met Logan when he was like 12 years old or something like that. You know, 10 years old, I met Logan. Yeah. And the first thing he said to me was, "Sir, do you know how many bones are in the dog's body?" And I looked at him. I was like, "No." And he said, "Well, it depends." And he broke that shit down to me. Like, it could be, I can't remember the specific number, but it could be, three more bones more because of a certain thing with the, and I was fucking impressed with this kid. Like, just came up and he just, you know, that was his way of saying hello to me, you know. Yeah. And I had to realize that, you know what I'm saying? And you know, he loved Waffle House, and you know, and he, you know, loved Siren and things that we had going on with Tone. And this before I had shots or anything like that. So you know, yeah. I met him when he was super young, man. And I went up to his mom and dad. I was like, "Man, you know what he just asked me?" You know, you know what I'm saying? And it created a relationship from there. You know, I called him my nephew, you know what I'm saying? Anything, nobody can say nothing wrong to him at a show, you know? So do you, I know you really don't have a bond like that with the show world, because you're kind of basically on your own and you do your thing. But that, I became a fan of you when I honestly, when I found out you was a professional soccer player and your age and how you carry yourself, man. You was like around 21 years old. And I'm like, man, my, you know, I got a son that's around your age. And I'm like, man, you know, this is how I would want my son to be. You know what I'm saying? And it's just made me proud to see a brother like yourself, man, doing it the right way, man, not cutting corners and actually doing it the right way. What would you say to these young brothers that are coming into the game? Not just young brothers, just young people that are coming into the game with their eyes wide open. What would you tell them when they're trying to get into the hustle and bustle of this dog world?
First, I'll say just take your time. Don't rush it. Because I feel like what messes up a lot of people is that first, if that first investment is wrong, or, you know, you buy the wrong, you know, people rush in and buy anything. Or a lot of people, even with whelping, I see a lot of people take losses on the first litter. Just want to rush and do something. The female that ate all the puppies. Just like rushing into stuff. If you don't know what you're doing, you know, like, because honestly, before I bought Bad Medicine, I used to scroll on Facebook in them groups for, I was a junior in college when I bought him. So since freshman year, it was 2 years I scrolled before I ever bought a dog.
How old were you when you bought him? You was like 20 years old?
I had 21. To be, yeah, 20, probably 20. I think when I went to Jacksonville the first time with him, I was 21. So
that was the first Jacksonville show. That was the COVID show.
Yeah, the first one.
And so, man, I wish I would have took a picture with you, man, that show. But shit was moving so, I didn't know that show was gonna be like that, bro.
Nah, that was a nice one. I enjoyed that one.
How many lock-ins did you get during that show?
Oh, I think when I got home, I probably had about 8.
Dog, that was...
on the drive home, about 8.
Dog, that was.
It was a nice show, man. I might have thought that going to shows though.
That's how you, because to be honest, in this dog world, it's what's that saying? Basically, if you're not around, people are going to forget you. Yeah. You know, people are not, you're going to lose inquiries on your dogs. And, you know, people get upset when they think they automatically, you know, like, I know that people are gonna fall off of shots fired, you know, if I'm not, don't have him out there, you know. That's why I'm doing his last, his curtain call, you know. I'm doing his last, this is, I think I've done nationals with him twice before. This is going to be third nationals, you know, so this is going to be his last one. And so this is his current call form. And, you know, I'm not going there to win, you know, I'm going there just to display him to everybody, you know, in the bully world. I honestly think you should be doing the same thing with that beast that you got over there. I know you have other dogs coming up, but that dog needs to be shared with the world, because I honestly think that he is a slept on dog, man. You know, for what the dog brings to the table. What's his bloodline?
So, you know, his dad is a maestro.
Okay.
And then his mom is off Lucky.
Okay.
Yeah. So a unique pedigree.
Right. Believe. But definitely a unique pedigree.
And that's where he throws all that. Cause I mean, every litter, he's throwing lilacs every litter. That's where he's getting that color from, maestro. People always asking, you know, why he breed him to a dog. And people are like, everything was lilac tribe. I'm like, well, you know, it comes from his father.
So do you do you ever take him on any tournaments or anything like that? Anybody, the players to see him, you know, associate, like bring him out to see people and stuff like that? Do you bring him out a lot?
So honestly, it's kind of crazy. So that's honestly one of the reasons why he hasn't been able to go to shows, because living in downtown Atlanta, you know, it's I guess what they say, a lot of rich people. When right. I take him outside, when puppies are sold, I mean, I walk out to let him use the bathroom. And the litter is sold. Whatever next right. puppy I sold. So I go to a lot of these parks and stuff around Atlanta, take him outside. And he's so big in Atlanta that he's so always busy. Like, I was going to go to the Stack Off last week. He had to knock out 4 breedings in the last 2 weeks.
Man. So, you're busy. You're busy. So you're basically saying you're not chasing that because you already have a name for the dog already.
Yeah, and see, I won't lie. Honestly, I personally want to. Okay, so this is actually another thing that I kind of feel like would be good advice for the younger breeders. So this is something I noticed. Depending on the region you live in, you'll reach certain clientele. That's what I feel like. And living in the South, I feel like people don't have the type of females that they have in the Midwest. So a lot of times when I see, like, they'll say a stud is a producer, every female that they're breeding to is up to par.
Right.
Down here, you have a lot of people who are trying to get a female that's up to par.
Right.
So when people look at how Bad Medicine produces, some people will be like, well, the females don't, you know, they don't even look like they should have been bred. And then the puppies end up looking amazing. But then you have some people with studs where, you know, like the bigger name studs in the Midwest, their females that they're breeding to look like the damn studs.
Right.
It's rare. It's rare in our region in South. Well, you have some people, but it's rare that a lot of people have females like that in the South, Southeast, in the Southeast, especially in Georgia.
What I personally, I'm not going to say don't like. But what I wouldn't want in my yard are those super small dogs, you know, those like micro dogs, you know. Or I have a dog right now that's 13 inches and a quarter, and I'm about to get rid of her, you know what I'm saying? Because like, she's super small. You know, I'm a seller with a breeding to the person who I'm getting it to. I'm a seller with a breeding of shots just to see what, you know, I can do, what happens, you know what I'm saying? But I see those dogs are becoming micros. Are you going towards the micro dog, or are you trying to stay in the pocket range?
I'm not going towards micro. I mean, it's crazy. So I off of that brim litter that I ran Bad Medicine to the brim daughter, I have a female that I kept. She's, you know, looking like him and brim. And one, she's a lilac try as well, but she's,
man, you gotta send me some pictures, brother. Please send me some pictures. I ain't gonna share with nobody. Just let me see the pictures, man.
Oh no, I'll show you. She's
please, man. Damn, man.
I'm kind of trying to see how tall she's gonna be, because she's probably around 13 and a half. And she's shorter than any dog I have right now, but it's just, I guess that's what, sometimes they pull that out, them pedigrees, because, you know, I didn't expect none of them to be that short, but she's barely over 13 and a half inches right now. But I like the taller, I like the 15 inch dogs. I don't want to go too much shorter than that.
Right. That's what's up, man. So how did you get the opportunity to play professional soccer? How did that come into play?
So my dad is from the Virgin Islands, so they, you know, you have to be eligible for each country, either by like your parents or you have to be a citizen. A citizen, parents, grandparents. I think those are the only ways you can play for a country. So growing up, I actually, when I was 17, I was supposed to sign with Atlanta United. That's the MLS team here.
Right.
And got injured. So got injured, went to college, ended up playing D1. And then after D1, I went straight to, you know, start playing for them. So I've been playing for them ever since.
So how long has that been? And what position do you play?
I play left back, and I've been on the team since I was 18. Of course, when I first started playing, I couldn't get paid, you know, because I was in school.
Okay, right.
So yeah, I started when I was 18, but I've been on I've been playing with the men's team since then.
Wow, man. So are you looking to get into the MLS?
I'm negotiating contracts right now, but
wow,
the funny thing is with MLS is, so, you know, there's youth teams for like each club, you know, you can
right.
play for
child. It's like a farm league basically.
Yeah, so how it works, and I feel like a lot of people don't know, in America, for instance, like I played for Atlanta United's youth team. But how it works is, once you go to college and then when you graduate, that team has first dibs on you. So you can't go to another team unless that team says that you know, they release you. So the problem that a lot of people have with soccer is they don't want to play for the team that they played for as a youth. And then, you know, you got to get them to release you and all that. So, you know, long story.
It's a headache, especially if you're a good player. They're like, we don't want to let you go.
Exactly. So
they hold you hostage.
That's exactly what happens, and that's what's been going on with a lot of young players in America.
So do players mostly that are superstars, like dual citizenship players, such as yourself? I'm not going to ask you that because this is like live. You know, but if I was in that situation and I know I could do better, I would try to negotiate something on so I could get picked up on a lower scale to get paid more on the back end. If you get what I'm saying, you know, like I'm not gonna put it all out there, because I know if I do, then they're gonna put that gun in my chest and be like, please, you know, please don't leave me. You know, I would take that slug to the chest. So do they pay you comparable to what the MLS pays?
So if you honestly, it just depends on
if you're that player.
Yeah, it depends on that performance, and it also depends on, you know, when you play internationally, you're not playing all the time like how the MLS is. So
right.
when you're in season, you're getting paid, you know. World right. Cup come around, during the World Cup qualifiers, you having 2-3 games, you know, back to back to back to back for months, you getting paid.
How does that feel, brother? How does that feel to be in that situation, man? How does that feel?
It's a blessing, man. It's especially, like, you know, with my team right now, we're in a transitional phase because we're young right now. So my whole team is young. So
I wish you was Trinidadian, man.
Yeah, man. We supposed to play them one day, but you know, they just played in America the other day, actually.
I know they was doing a couple of years ago. They had a decent team, man. I don't know what happened since then. So
they still good.
Okay. All right.
They just, you know,
They need somebody like you on there to be Trini.
And all them countries have a lot of what's the word? Dang, what you I cannot think of the word. Within the like the associations and within the program, what do you call it? Dang, I can't think of the word.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, it'll come to me. It'll come to me.
Man. All right. So how do you manage both a breeding program and soccer? Do you have is your parents doing it? Do you have a wife or a girl that you have? I don't mean to pry, but I'm just asking, you know, do you have a surrounding cast around you for to handle your dogs, or do you have people like me, not me, but like people like in the bully world that you say, you know what, I'm gonna do this co-own with you, you know, yeah. and I this is how I'm gonna get rid of my dogs that I want to keep, not get rid of them, but you know, still have a hand in it, you know, right. Do you do it like that, or do you have somebody that actually is like hands on when you're gone?
So you know, I like to keep my number. Well, I'm big on quality, so I have a Frenchie stud that's, you know, he's pretty busy. And then I had two females. Well, I had the female I was telling you about. I had the one, the muscle tone. I had her. I had a daughter of hers, but she passed.
Oh, sorry to hear about that, brother.
Yeah, man, that was rough. So I have her, and then I have the other one off Bram that I kept. So I have three females. Then I have Bad Medicine. And then I have the Frenchie stud. So, you know, when I go out of town, it's not too hard to have somebody, you know, keep them. Okay. And if somebody needs to do a breeding, I have Daniel. I know, you know, Rhino Valley.
Right. Yes, sir.
Yeah. He stays right down the street from me. So, you know, if they need to do AIs or, you know, they need to do any breedings, he'll, you know, help out. So that's really my guy.
That's what's up to have somebody like that, man, that will help out, man, you know, when because a breeding that thing just pops up, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, so and a lot of people don't relay the message to you right away, you know, when they see the dog bleeding, they probably wait a couple of days and just be like, oh shit, you know, let me hit him up. Now it's like 8 more days until, you know, this breeding. So you gotta let the person know, you gotta let your boy know what's going on and relay the message to him. He don't know what time they're gonna hit it. So that's a beautiful thing, man. Yeah, to have somebody, that's a blessing.
It's a lot. And I think I feel like a lot of people don't really understand how it is to have a stud that's busy, because it can, man, it can get hectic. Like when I first started with him, it was, man, I was stressed. I was running up and down every day. But right, you know, once you get the hang of it, it's, but I feel like if people think it's a walk in the park, like it's just,
it's not
easy. It's not at all. Not at all.
When I seen the both of you, I was amazed by him, but I was amazed by you were stacked up by him too. I can't remember the dog's name. It's the brother that owns the dump company.
Tony, Luca.
Yes, Luca Brazzi. And then y'all was stacked up next to each other, weren't y'all?
Yeah.
Yo, man. People don't understand that was the most epic. That was probably the most epic show I ever been to.
Yeah.
You know, that where it was, I'm not gonna say hundreds, but it was damn near close to 100 people that was surrounding, you know, the stack stage.
Yeah.
And it was crazy because you could feel the excitement in the air. And it was just like a honor to be a part of. And it was an honor to be on the stage with you, Luca Brazzi and Tony. Man, it was such an honor to have all of those dogs. It was Cash out there. That's what put Cash on the map. Show put Cash on the map. People don't understand Tone Rodan show, that first Jacksonville show, put Cash on the map.
Yeah, that was the
nobody one. Really didn't know about that dog, man, you know what I'm saying? But that's what I'm saying, that's how big that show was. It put dogs on. you know? And so it put shots fired on another level, even though he wasn't a stack up dog. You know, he's a show dog, you know? He don't have those extreme features, you know, like your dog has, or Luca Brasi. I was just happy to be up there with y'all, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And talking shit, you know, that's just was my thing, you know. How did it feel to be up there? How did it feel to be? Was that your first show that you went to?
Stacking wise, yeah, that was the first show.
How did you like it?
It was fun. It made me want to keep going to them. I went to, I think I kept going to them for like, I know
you
I
caught the bug. You caught the bug, huh?
I was ready every time they said something. People was messaging me like, yeah, we need you here. I was like, all right. I went to one in South. I know I went to South Carolina the week after, and all of them guys went to that one too.
Right.
But Jeremiah took Golden Child to that one instead of Cash.
Okay.
So we went to South Carolina, stacked there. That was a good show. You know, they gave out medals and plaques. I think I went to like three more shows after that, stack offs and stuff. Before I stopped because he got so busy. But I mean, it's no feeling like that, you know.
I try to tell people that in the dog game, that it's like sports, right? You have the people that get paid, like LeBron James. You got Harden. You got players like that, you know, the top tier players, and you got those other players that's not making that much money, you know, that's, you know, but they're making good money though. Yeah. But then you got the players that's D league players. Then you got the players that's park ball players. And you got the, you know, high school, you know, you got the lower tier. I try to tell people it's just like that, man. And you have a dog that's in the NBA. That's an NFL player. How does it feel? Have you ever stepped outside and how did you, how I'm trying to form this question. When did you realize this dog was this big? Like, when did you realize this dog is that big, man? That I didn't know he was this huge in the world. When did you realize that?
So when I first got him, like, I knew he was going to be special. The only thing I was kind of like contemplating on was more so like how he would fit in as far as color, because you know so many people chase color. Mm-hmm. I already knew he would be one of the, like, as soon as I got him, I knew he would be one of the biggest dogs in the world. Because so Charlie, actually, like I was saying, he was a big breeder back then, the guy who produced him. He was supposed to set up a stack off between, like, I don't think it was Bashar. I believe it was whoever had Nemesis overseas. I can't remember the guy's name. And the guy was supposed to come to America and stack with a few dogs, you know, go place to place. And that was supposed to be one of the first, that was before the Jacksonville show. That was supposed to be one of the first stack offs that he was supposed to do, was supposed to be with Nemesis. That was before I would have ever taken him to a show. But around the, you know, the same time, this is when, you know, when COVID came. So it never ended up happening. But once I got him, cropped his ears, and, you know, like I said, Daniel's the photographer, start taking pictures. I start posting him up. Like, I knew he was blowing up. But then when I went to that show and I was like, you know, you get on that stage and
you can see that, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Cool.
And what really kind of made me realize that he was special was when I was at the show. And I realized, like, when it came to the extreme pockets, all of those other pockets were off the same bloodlines. He was the only one who had a different bloodline. So I knew that people would be attracted to him if they ever wanted to get that look, but go a different route. Because, you know, nowadays everybody wants the next big thing. Like, so once I realized, like, you know, he's the only, because I mean, as far as the pockets go, I think it was, like you said, Luca, Baby Cakes, Cash, you know, that's all, you know, Rocco blood.
Right.
So I had a lot of people who were hitting me up like, wow, he's up there, you know, just as extreme with them, but different bloodline. And it was catching, you know, he started catching attention because everybody wants the next big thing. So after that, I was like, yeah, he's going to be busy, and got back and he's been busy ever since.
Man, it's a blessing, man. Hey, congratulations to you and everything that you got going on, man. I know you don't need the business, but can you drop your information, your social media, so your camp name, and so people can get in contact with you, because we've been holding like a good 20 people in here at a time. So, you know, I know people in the future is going to see this, man, because a lot of people watch my videos on the back end and hit me up after that. And they're like, man, I didn't even know that person. You know, I didn't even know that dog, man. I hit that person up for a stud fee. And I'm like, oh, yeah. You know, so I'm glad that I can be a part of, you know, of helping people find a stud, you know, or a dog, or pick a puppy or something like that. I'm glad to be a part of that. So could you please add to your busyness and give everybody social media, your information, so they can get on?
I try to put it in the chat. Did it show up? Or can you see it? It didn't.
Nah. I'd have to go into our private chat.
Oh, okay. So how can I, or should I just say it?
Yeah, just say it. Yeah, say it. Okay. Because people can play it back. You know, if you got to spell it, you know, you spell it just in case. People see your name right there. So, you know.
Yeah, so that's my Instagram is Muscular Bullies, M-U-S, color, C-O-L-O-R, Bullies. And then my Facebook is Zahmyre Harris, Zahmyre Harris. I think that's about the only social media I got right now.
And respect the man's time. He's busy, man. Don't be pump faking with this man. Yo, don't, because he ain't got no time for it. Yeah. Y'all window shoppers, man. Y'all go somewhere else, man. This brother ain't got no time, man. You know, he ain't got no time for your BS, man. He's not a mentor. He's not your mentor. He's not one. He's like Charles Barkley. You know what Charles Barkley is like? I am not your role model. You know what I'm saying? You know, he'll probably answer a few of your questions, but I'm telling you, the brother's busy. Don't, you know, he's not like some of the other guests that I have on that have the time, you know, like the judges and everything that come on, and where they that's what they do. You know, they feel that's their job, is to answer questions with other. This brother is not that brother. All right. Yeah. So don't waste his brother time, man. You know, be in and out with this guy, you know. So don't do it like that, man. He don't need friends. He's a professional soccer player, all right? He don't need no friends, man. The man's good, man. You know what I'm saying?
I wish I could flip the camera, but does it let me flip it? It won't let me use the back.
Yeah,
camera.
You have to go into the, man, you have
it's
to go.
It's a lot, ain't it?
Oh my god, you have to go into the settings, and it's stupid, man. I wish it was easy. Oh, okay. Okay. How old is that puppy?
She just turned 2.
She?
Yeah, that's a girl. That's what I mean by the females that I'm here.
She 2 years old?
Yeah.
Man, that's a pop. Yo, bro.
Yeah, that's the one who will probably be going to him next.
Man, look at her shoulders.
Yeah, she's some serious. That's
who. Damn it, man. Man, but I don't want to hold you up any longer. I know you're busy, man. I know you got stuff that you got going on, even though it's a Monday. I know it's every day is like a Friday for you, probably. So, you know. Yeah. I don't want to be a burden that I've already been on your day. I appreciate you being on my platform, man. I honestly, it's an honor to have somebody like you and a dog that you have on this platform, because I put you up there with people like Ashton, you know what I'm saying? And like Tone, and people don't fucking know, like in the bully world, they don't know what's going on, you know, but you really don't give a damn, because you already know what you already got your shit right, you know what I'm saying? And that's admirable, because you don't have to beg to know damn bully world that, you know, my dog is the best, because you already know you got the damn dog.
Definitely. And see, the only thing I kind of feel like I wouldn't say holds me back, but the only thing that, you know, keeps me from being way up there, in my opinion, is that I keep getting my hands on females that come in heat once a year.
Okay.
I can only produce so much when they only, my feet, like the one I just showed you, she only come in every 10 months.
They rock into your schedule though.
Yeah. It, I mean, hey, you just got to have patience because, man, them 10 Facts. Months take forever to go by, man.
But Facts, man. Man, I apologize for the Sunday that I missed, man. I told you, man, the brother hit me up and was told me, man, he had his female that he was driving down from New York with, man, you know. So he came down, you know, he spent the night. We did two breedings, you know. So I apologize, man, but I'm glad that you had the time for me today, or made the time for me today, man. I really appreciate it, man. I salute to you, man. I'm giving you your flowers, man. And people, everybody that's watching this or that is going to watch this in the near future that's not on his live, if you don't know who Bad Medicine is, go to Google American Bully Bad Medicine, and it's the badass motherfucking blue and white dog that is he pie is he a pie blue and white dog that got the crop ears, you know. Yeah. So just understand that's the bad motherfucker that we talking about. And yeah. he left his information. Get at him, man. And like I said, man, don't waste his time. This brother is not a mentor to none of y'all. You know, do business with him. Let's be in and out.
Definitely.
Man, thank you so much, brother. I'm glad. It's an honor to have you on again. Man, you have a blessed night, man. And man, send me the pictures of them puppies, man, and keep me informed on when you I want to watch your games in the World Cup. So please keep me informed. And if you have any games before that where I can watch, please let me know, because I can watch games for free. I got that website that I go to.
Okay.
I can go into the site, I can watch any game that I want. So please let me know when you on so I can watch it, and I'll support you, man.
First one, all right? Coming up. I'm about to actually leave out now, out of town. I'll be leaving mid-August. First game I got this year, September 7th.
Text me the time. Text me the date. And I'm going to put it on my cell phone so I can watch that shit.
Okay. All right? Yeah, I'm going to send it to you as soon as I get off, bro. I appreciate you, man.
Man, I appreciate you, brother, man. Thank you so much, man.
No problem, man.
And, man, you stay blessed, man.
Okay, you too.
And we're going to run this back. We're going to spin the block on this when you got another badass dog, when that badass male that you got.
Oh yeah, definitely. Next time I have Bad Medicine here, I can put him.
It's fine, man. We showed that bad motherfucker look like, man. So you be easy, man. You stay blessed, fam.
All right, you too. Now I appreciate it.
Yes, sir. Yeah, appreciate you. Yo, so this is what we do, man. What I'm planning to do is to start advertising people's studs. Right, I'm gonna start advertising people's studs for a fee. Oh, you can run it back. You can run it back, broom. You can run it back, man. You can spend a block on it. Now I'm about to end it right now. You know what I'm saying? You know, I don't want to keep the brother too long, man, because he's a very, very busy person. It's cool. It's cool, Jerry, man. It's all right, man. It's fine, man. Salute to Mr. Jerry James in the building. Salute to Kelvin Marshall. That's my brother. Nick Angry Ink, Chris Landrum. Shout out to you, brother. Malik Kelly for always coming on, man. Comment. And I seen your question, and you were right. Females are very underappreciated. And what I have next for Shots Fired is I'm going to breed him with some World Star blood, you know, some two-time World Star blood, and see what we can do with that, man. And, you know, if it doesn't, it might not happen on the first take. I might have to breed the puppies back to something else. I don't know. We gonna find out. But how would I say? I'm very confident in the breeding with Shots Fired and Pup Smoke. Hey, shout out to the 401 for show, man. 401 strong for show. You already know that. You already know it's 401 for show. Providence, Warwick, West Warwick, where are we talking about? Greenwich. you know what I'm saying? Cranston, Cumberland. You damn right. Shout out to the 401, man. All of the 401. King Charles, shout out to you, brother. Yo, man, you know what I'm saying? I miss Rhode Island, man. That Rhode Island's home to me, man. He said, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know, you relate to Greenwich. You be hanging out on a block in Greenwich when it's time to do them breedings, Nick. Come on now. You know what? Private chat was right here. I could have seen it. My bad, Zahmyre, man. I'm slow, brother. I'm slow. So, I think I'm going to come on tomorrow and we're going to do some. So, I'm about to play myself out. Y'all boys be easy.
Loving what you do and doing what you do with the pure enjoyment of knowing that you're the best at what you do. Okay. Yo, couldn't nobody fuck with me then. Couldn't nobody fuck with me now, yo. Can't be serious, yo. Can't no fucking body fuck with me with this rap shit, yo. Check it. I've been spitting for 20 years.
Hold up. Sorry, I had to stop. I just wanted to say this real quick. I'm sorry that I'm not a gossip channel. I'm sorry that I don't talk about the latest information and bullshit that's going on. I'm sorry that I don't shove down that bullshit down your throat. What I try to bring you on this channel, is quality interviews, something that you can learn, people that you can learn from. That's why I do this. You know, and shout out to everybody that stays tuned in, man. That stays locked into the No Bullish TV, man. I appreciate y'all. Please like, share, comment. Man, I really, really, really appreciate y'all. I've been seeing a lot of that bullshit going around, so-called news in the bully world, man. Come on, man. Teach the people something. Let's teach the people something. Let's give the people some kind of light through the tunnel. Fuck at the end of the tunnel, because we done crawled through that bullshit. Let's come back and save those people. This is what this show is about. I'm crawling back and I'm putting up lights through that tunnel so I don't have to be no light at the end of the tunnel. You know what I'm saying? So you can see all the way through, not just from me, but from other people that you can gain experience from, that's guest on my show. So please, man, please keep it going, man. I'm going to keep it going. And mad respect to the people that that stay tuned in and locked in. I appreciate y'all.
Loving what you do and doing what you do with a pure enjoyment of knowing that you're the best at what you do. Okay. Yo, couldn't nobody fuck with me then. Couldn't nobody fuck with me now, yo. Can't be serious, yo. Can't nobody, no fucking body fuck with me with this rap shit, yo. Check it. I've been submitting for 20 years.
Sometimes I smile to hide the miles of my road travel. Shake my hand, it felt like you just touched the stove handle. Holy cow, fuck the cow, I want the whole cattle. Gucci buffs on my eyes look like solar panels. Leaving bitches on their own like the Oprah Channel. Can't trust my shadow, that's a fact that can't get overshadowed. Draco sounding like he's coughing from the smoking barrel. No peace, no serenity, nigga, breaking your vicinity. Nigga, like virginity, nigga, ain't into these niggas. Just family like the Genovese, nigga, the Kennedys. Nigga, all street niggas ain't in the streets, nigga. Best rapper, ex-trapper, dressed dapper. Swizzy gave me a hair banger, a neck snapper. X-Factor, make a rapper an X-sample. All I need is a beat with a DMX sample.
All I need is a beat with a DMX sample. Say it with your chest, mama. Say less, mama. We's the F and the F is for F-bomber. Yes, mama, I'ma eat you like Jeff Dahmer. Say she on a period, let's make a mess, mama. Don't be on all of that, yeah, that my twin shit, all right? Don't hit my phone with all that, I'm just tapping in shit, all right? Fuck that friend shit, all right? I'm on my Zen shit, all right? I'm on that DMT, I ain't on that DM shit, all right? Trying to get a B right now, I'm on my M shit, all right? I'm just Weezy, we on my, excuse my friend shit, all right? Fuck that bitch shit, all right? Red beam on the and she wore lipstick tonight. Blah, 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 blah. Best rapper, ex-trapper, dressed dapper. Swizzy gave me a headbanger, a neck snapper. X-Factor, make a rapper an X-sample. All I need is a beat with a DMX sample. Swizzy on the drum machine, I got the gun machine. That bitch go brrrr, sound like bumblebees. Gun come with a magazine, long as a limousine. You smell that decomp in the morning like some Jimmy Dean's. Best rapper, ex-trapper, dressed dapper. Swizzy gave me a headbanger, a neck snapper. All I need is a beat with a DMX sample. All I need is a beat with a DMX sample.